Morning, dear faculty members and the students. So once again, welcome to this webinar. And today we are having the second part of the module that we started the last week. And hello, everybody. I'm Dr. Sandeep Ranjan, Associate Professor and Dean, School of Engineering and Technology, APJ Institute of Management and Engineering Technical Campus, Jalandhar. So we have started with the concept of multi-skill disciplinary courses. Therein, we aim to provide the students skill sets which are over and above the regular curriculum. So these days, you need all these skills to get a good job and also to enhance your skill set. So once again, I welcome everybody. And I'm going to start the webinar within a moment. Some people are still in the waiting room. So I'll begin with the recap of the last week's study module that we covered. And anybody who had any difficulty in any of the concepts, they can raise their hand or they can unmute their mic and start with the question. So we had a brief introduction about the institute, what courses we are running, and what is the level of teaching learning that we have over here. There's a list of faculty members. So we started with the concept of social network analysis. I break this phrase into individual words: social network and analysis. So by the word social, I mean all those living species which are socially dependent on each other. There are some species which do not interact, or they have minimal interaction with the individuals of the same species. So by virtue of nature, by the gift of nature, we humans, dolphins, ants, and many other animals are very social. Their lives are quite dependent on each other, and we seek each other's help and we are happy to help each other. So this way our social relationships, they grow, and we also keep on adding more and more people in our social networks. So earlier people used to talk to each other. Right now also they talk to each other. The moment they met anybody in the train, in the bus, in the college, in the neighborhood. So those were the social interactions. So with the advent of internet and affordable internet, if I say, the revolution brought by smartphones and 4G and fiber and broadband. So especially in our country, like we have seen for the last 6 or 7 years, there has been a flood of internet and other technologies, which has enabled us to connect to social networks. So social networks earlier also were there. Now we have online social networks. So be it any type of social networks, network means any interaction of entities. Okay, a television and a remote, they also form a network, wherein the remote sends some data to the TV and the TV acts according to that. So social and network are clear. Analysis means let us break this and learn how it is made up of and how we can improve and how it grows so that we can benefit from the social networks. So we learned that about 5 billion people right now, they have access to the internet, affordable internet, if I say, and they are actively using the social networks for their mutual benefit. And this figure is growing with every day. So we see that the billions of people are connected on Facebook, and millions of them are connected on Twitter, Instagram, Yahoo. And also when you post any comment on any of the YouTube videos, it becomes a network. You post your comment on a video and somebody likes or dislikes, and the chain goes on. Okay, that's also a social network, online social network. Others are LinkedIn, WhatsApp. So specifically LinkedIn is for your career growth, professional growth. Like on Facebook, we use it more commonly for entertainment. Twitter is also for entertainment and political discussions and some other discussions. LinkedIn is specifically for career growth and professional growth, and also for business growth. So WhatsApp is a very popular online messenger. Instagram is there. So how do networks they form whenever we talk to each other, whenever we like, dislike, share, comment, shake hands. Nowadays, we don't shake hands. So this becomes a network. So network keeps on growing, and we learned that there's an experiment, small world experiment. So I just want to check with my audience. Does anybody remember what is a hop and how many hops do we need to connect on an average with any other random individual anywhere in the world? Any comments on this? What is a hop that we learned in the last lecture? And what would be the average number of hops that you would require to connect to any human being? Considering the fact that the current population of the world is 7.4 billion. Yes, Ankita?
So it's 8 hops are there on an average.
And what is a hop?
So it's a jump from one person to another.
So whenever our communication goes from one node to another, so every one of us is a node. Okay. So if this person wants to share some message over here, so either it is this way, one hop and two hops, or it could be like one, two, and three. Fine. So hops mean how many nodes you have to traverse while communicating with any random node. Okay. So if the population of the world is, entire world is 7.4 billion, and we had seen that some rewiring is also there, like this. This is rewiring. This is a straight chain. Appears to be a straight chain, but this has more connections over here also. So in a well-connected graph, there are more than one path. So obviously the number of hops comes down when we have more rewiring. And we also learned that graphs are the best way to understand the social networks. So here is a graph of a research paper network. So we learned about the basic terminology of graphs, which you would have already covered in your mathematics, basic mathematics. So these lines which connect any two nodes are called edges, and any entity, any individual, anything yet that you are discussing about, that is a node, okay, or a vertex. Some fundamental terminologies. Important one is degree. How many edges are connected to your node? That is your degree, and how many are incoming towards you? Okay, that is your in degree, and how many are outward connecting your node to other nodes? So it is, if the arrow is like this, if I point my finger, it is an out degree. If it is like this coming towards me, it is an in degree. So we had a concept of unweighted and weighted edges. Let's say from my home to the APJ Institute, the distance is, suppose it is 18 kilometers. So I'll write 18 over here. This is my home and this is my institute. So I'll write 17 or 18, whatever kilometers. Or it could be the number of traffic lights, or it could be the number of liters of petrol that I consume on my two-wheeler or my four-wheeler, or could be anything. Time also. Okay. So directed and undirected graphs. So if there is an arrow marked, then it is a directed graph. If this arrow is missing, then it is an undirected graph. Graphs can be better understood if we create a matrix for a given graph. So if I have a graph like this, so the nodes are labeled like A to I, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. These are the nodes. And if there is a straight line, which is an edge, if there is a line edge between any two nodes, we will write a one over there. Okay. In the previous table, we saw that there is an edge between A and D, and D has got many edges, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we will see 4 ones in the row of D. So here it is D, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this one is loop, self loop. So if D is connected to D itself, there will be a loop because it is corresponding to this row and this column. So in a graph where we don't have any self loops, we can simply put a hyphen Okay. Otherwise, if there is an edge between any two given nodes, we will put a 1, else we will put a 0. So this makes understanding of the graph easier for us and also for the computers, because we know that computers, they understand 0 and 1 only. So for a computer, for a software, for a tool, for a programming language, if we want to input a graph, the other side will understand it like this. How many zeros and how many ones and between whom? So it is, I is not connected to just for a small fraction of time, just recall this, that I is not connected to any other node, but it is connected to H. Let us verify. So I is connected to D. It should be a 1 over here. I'll correct it. It should be a 1 over here. I is connected to G, not connected to H. Okay. So we have these diagrams and table. So we learned about degree. We learned about in degree and out degree. And the last lecture, we did some exercises about how many, what is the in degree and out degree for each of these nodes. And we got tables like this. And then we had a concept of communities. So a community is a region of a graph, like you can say graph and a subgraph, where there are more connections amongst the nodes, okay, compared to the connections between this region and this region. So here is, this node is having only one connection with this region, but it is having two connections over here. So two connections is greater than this one connection. And similarly, so we identify these are regions. Like we say, India is a culturally diverse country. So more people from Punjab, they talk to each other than compared to anybody from Punjab giving a call to anybody in Manipur. Okay, so Manipur is a separate community and Punjab is a separate community. So we are well connected in India and we love each other. And there is no concept of physical communities over here. It is just like we are geographically sitting over here and the language is different. Otherwise, they are well connected in India. So some graphs from the nature. Dolphin social network, we learned about social network amongst dolphin. Okay. So who talks to whom? And similarly, a food web network where the relationship is not as gloomy as a relationship between any other individuals. It is like who eats whom? Who kills whom? If a node kills another node, we have an edge between them and so like this. So not every animal likes to eat every other animal. So we have separate communities of who eats whom. So this is just a different layout of the same graph. We will learn about these today. So two communities labeled with different colors. Okay. Many nodes are here and we have successfully labeled. These belong to one community, red ones, and the blue ones, they belong to the other community. So when we have many, many communities, the graph looks like this. And in due course of time, you will be able to create these types of graphs also. Firstly, it requires a lot of understanding of graphs and social networks. Secondly, main hindrance is your hardware should be very, very updated. You need to have a very large amount of RAM, like 16 or 32. Okay, you need to have a latest processor and you need to have a graphics core processor also. It's a video card in layman's term. Okay. So then you will be able to create these ones. We will start from the basic ones. Okay, social networks again, and some social networks, specific ones. The Dolphin social network. It's all a recap of the previous lecture, the degree of social networks. So we have some dolphins who had a degree of 1. Might be they are very young and they are communicating with one of the parents only. And then there are some old dolphins, quite popular dolphins, who have a high degree. And we also talked about the karate club in the US. And we had train bombing network in the Spanish metro trains. So this is how a network on YouTube grows. Like, so a popular video might get a lot of attention. Okay, you come across some videos which are by some singers or some actors. So a lot of people watch them, and many of them like also, share also. So it becomes a connection between my username on YouTube and that video. So edges grow like this, and some people respond to somebody else's comment. So there's a chain also. This is an individual comment, and this is a comment to a comment. So this becomes a chain. Online word of mouth. What is word of mouth? If I say this shop or this thing is very good, okay, the services of this service center is good, okay, and you listen to me and you pass on the same message to somebody else, and this is the physical word of mouth, okay, the natural word of mouth. And on social networks, if the word travels like this from one node to another, it is an online word of mouth, okay. Anywhere, if you're not clear or you were not there or you missed some part of this last week, you can ask me. A very revolutionary experiment in the field of social network analysis is the small world experiment by this researcher, commonly referred to by this name, Milgram experiment. Okay, so he did this experiment of rewiring. So if there are some reconnections between the nodes, then the number of hops comes down. Otherwise, 7.3 billion, I would take about 100 hops. I would call somebody, you know, somebody in Argentina, then that person will call somebody in some remote town of Argentina, and it will take some hops. Okay, but because we have multiple connections, like I have, suppose, 800 connections on Facebook, and one of my Facebook friends has 2,000 connections. So if they like my post, so it grows like this. So then we had this video also. So starting with the graph visualization. Visualization means to picturize something, to display something. Okay. So this is plain number and matrices and mathematics to make it more interesting and more revealing. So we can represent this table in the form of a graph, node B and D, and then there is some edge weight, or it may be not there. The weight may be not there. Okay. Direction or undirection may be not there. But if we talk source node and destination node, it will be an arrow from B leading to D. Okay. So arrow from B leading to D, and similarly from D to E, and from E to A. So all this is written over here. So some software packages like NodeXL, Python, MATLAB, R, FE, and many of them are there. Hundreds of them are there. We can convert this type of data into graphs, or the vice versa. If you feed them with the graph, they can convert them back into a CSV file, which is comma separated value. It's just another type of Excel file. So normally, whenever you work on Microsoft Excel, it gives you the choice .xls or recent most .xlsx. So you can save it like .csv. So that is the default file extension for social network analysis. It retains the relationship data, metadata that is called. The graph visualization, you can do these simple exercises on your notebook so that you get a hold of what social network analysis is. Okay, A to B, yes, you will write here A and B. For B, you will write C, B and C, then C and E, and so on. So the number of rows in this table would be equivalent to the number of edges over here. We also learned last lecture that the number of edges will be far, far more than the number of nodes. Because it's a well-connected network, for example, Facebook, the number of nodes, it is about 3 billion people are there on Facebook. The fact may not be very correct because it keeps on changing every other day. Okay, billions of people are there on Facebook, but there are far, far more connections, maybe of the order of 10 billion or 15 billion. It is a number of connections amongst these nodes. Similar exercise. So here is a summary of the previous lecture's concepts. Now we had an important concept of betweenness. Betweenness means who is lying at a very important location. Like if we say Kapurthala railway station is connected to Jalandhar, and Jalandhar railway station is well connected to most of the other railway stations in the neighborhood. Like we have a junction, a concept junction, where there are more than two railway lines. If I talk of railway station terminology, otherwise the junctions are there in electrical and network concepts also. So Jalandhar is well connected with Amritsar. Jalandhar is connected with Hoshiarpur, Firozpur, Kapurthala. Okay, but there are some railway stations which are not very importantly connected. So their betweenness degree is, or the measure of betweenness is quite less compared to the other popular nodes. So here we have different coloring schemes, and the coloring scheme depends on the betweenness value of a given node. Okay, so you can choose it from the lighter colors to the darker colors. Lighter means the betweenness is less, and the darker ones means the betweenness is higher. So here the betweenness of zero, you see, is quite less compared to four. So four is on the path from zero to any other conversation over here, this side, three to conversation over here, and six is quite popular. There are always some popular friends, or you can say students in the class networks, okay, who is friends with everybody else. Okay, so this is that type of human being or popular friend. Any information with the six will be readily spread to all other nodes because it is well connected with others and it is having a higher degree of betweenness. So similarly, five is connected with these nodes. So we also learned mining the social networks. So anybody who had tried to create an account or account on developer.twitter.com. So last time we learned about this. Okay, Ankita, you have raised your hand. Ankita, can you unmute and turn on your video? Ankita, can you turn on your video?
Yes, sir.
So, Ankita, were you able to create the credentials for yourself on Twitter website?
Yes, sir. I created some of it.
Sir. There were some question answers where? Yes.
Sir, I did the mining process, but I was not able to do the image one.
Okay. So which tool were you using last time or in between this gap?
Sir, NodeXL. I tried NodeXL only.
Okay. So you were able to install NodeXL on your laptop? Any difficulties?
No, sir. I was able to install.
So it is a very easy and small package that you just download and it integrates with Microsoft Excel. So you were able to mine something?
Yes, sir. I mined the Twitter tweets from the account that then I pasted in the NodeXL and then so, mining was done.
If you are using Zoom app on your laptop and you want to try your hands, I can allow you to share your screen later on in this lecture so that if you face any difficulty, I can help you out. And same message to everybody else who wants to learn this. Of course, theory is the most important thing because it's only when you know the theory you are able to demonstrate something. Okay, but practical helps you retain the concepts. Okay, theory makes you knowledgeable. Theory tells you what is there in this new concept, and practical gives you hands-on experience, and also you are able to retain that thing for a longer period of time. So if you don't do it, you just listen to the webinar and you just read the books about social network analysis, you might not be able to do it on your own the moment you need it. Okay. So mining the social networks, if you want to do it using some program, so depending upon the platform, these are the libraries. Okay. So I use Python and I am using PP. It's very popular among social network analysts. Okay. Otherwise, you can use any tool also. Tool means where you don't have to code. Things are readily available and you can just click and drag and drop things. That is called a tool. And this is called a programming platform. Okay. So either way you can do. So first thing is that you go to the website of Twitter, you create your Twitter account. Okay. And then you register yourself or you request developer.twitter.com to register your credentials as one of the developers who can mine Twitter tweets. So this may take some time. This may take some correspondence question and answer. Who are you and what do you want to do with the tweets? So there will be some communication with Twitter. And later on, they will approve your application and you will get all these four things. These are alphanumeric strings, long strings, which are unique. Okay, so that they cannot be easily copied by anybody else. So here is a URL and you can go to this place and start your registration. Something like this, you have to create an application over there. So you might have come across this word APIs. Everybody talks about APIs, application programming interface. So you create an application on the website of developer.twitter.com. And instead you talking to the application every time you create a programming interface on your behalf with your username and password, any tool on any programming language will be able to talk to Twitter website and they will download the data. Okay. You can put your laptop on sleep also. And there are some tools which work online also. Okay. You can shut down your laptop and still the API will keep on talking to the Twitter data set and it will be downloading whatever you had asked it. Now, this activity I had asked everybody to do, create a developer account. Okay. So some books are also there. You can check on Amazon or Google Books. Now, there was another activity that we learned last time, that find some time to identify one of your friends in the Facebook network. Okay. Explore their friends who are not your mutual friends. And keep on doing this and try to create a long chain of friend nodes so that you can do the hop thing. Okay. This is what you can do on pen and paper. Similarly, LinkedIn is a website and you type something and you get some suggestions that 15 or like this is a snapshot from my LinkedIn account. I search for a job. Postdoctoral researcher, okay, and some of the jobs were there. And the moment I clicked over here, it is showing me that 15 alumni, because I did my BTech MTech and PhD from the Punjab Technical University. So many people who have also done any of their qualification from Punjab Technical University, they're in my network. Because what is common between us? There is an edge from me to PTU. There is an edge from other people to PTU. So we are in a network, we are a community. Okay. So if anybody of them is working in this company, okay, Haze is a company, okay, might not be they're working at this designation, but then there is a community from PTU who is also working in this company and they can also help me. So this is the purpose of LinkedIn. It's purely for professional and business growth. So this is how social networks, they help us. And this was the last slide. And today we are going to start with the practicals. So there are a few tools that we can use. One of them is NetLogo. You can note down the name NetLogo, NetLogo. Okay. And it's an open source platform. Open source means the code is also available and the software product is also available. So the moment you install it, sometimes it may give you a prompt that some of the dependencies are also needed. Your system needs to have Java or system needs to be updated. Okay. So depending upon the version. The moment you open it, this type of window appears and you have to click on File, Models, Library. Okay. This is for learning how the social network work. Okay. Let me select any of the things like I click on. These are the subjects where we can find social networks. File. Just give me a minute. So if I select, so the bees, they are also social species. They talk to each other, they help each other, that hey, I have found some flowers over there in that direction, and it will tell to its friends, and friends of that particular A, B, okay, will tell it to others, and then this information spreads like this. Okay. It could be anything, the direction of sun, the temperature, humidity, the fragrance of flowers, or whatever the bee might be interested in. Okay, so you can set up this network. You can tweak parameters over here. Okay, hives are where the bees live. Okay, so before you run this network, just read or recall what you know about bees. Okay, so hives, you can increase the number of hives, initial percentage, and then explore time. These are some parameters on which the social network is dependent. So the number of iterations is very fast because the software and the computer, they are able to run these iterations at a very high speed. Otherwise, the bees might take some time to reach there and come back. So when we change, this social network is revealing how the bees, they work. And along with this, you get some real-time values which are of the interest of the social network analyst and maybe the scientists who are working in this particular domain of how the bees, they survive or something like this. And these values are very important for them. So why there is a sudden increase, why there's a dip, okay, why slant of this line is not changing. So it depends on what your purpose is to study the social network. Okay. Similarly, you pick in here. There's another interesting blood sugar regulation. So some people complain that they have a disease which is called diabetes type 1 and type 2. So just to study why it is not dissolving in the blood sugar, why it is saturating, and why do we need this medicine, or how much dose of this medicine is needed. These are very basic simulations to learn about social networks. Obviously, they are not going to give you the best results. The best results, they will come from very accurate data sets that you have. These are synthetic data sets. Whatever you visualization do you see over here, these are the synthetic data which is fed in this NetLogo software. To get correct results, you need to have a very, very vast data set which is accurate. Okay, and the results would be depending upon the accuracy and how do you tune your algorithm. That is into AI and machine learning. We should remain over here in the social networks, basics of social networks. So some parameters. This is, again, you eat something, okay, and depending upon these blood molecules may have different meanings. This is different molecules and different components of blood and something biological. So it keeps on going because living organisms, they keep on consuming sugar and it keeps on fluctuating. So it depends on these variables. Somebody from the medicine would be able to explain better. Again, a social network, all these colored dots are nodes, and then we have some interactions between amongst the nodes, and that leads to this up and down and haphazard behavior. You can correlate with entropy. How, sir? Entropy of gas molecules and Brownian motion, that is also a social network.
Right, sir. Bilkul.
Okay, so I'll show you some other social network. So this is where the fun begins. We have read a lot about the theory. Let us learn some fun activity also. This software is readily, freely available, open source software. Okay, you can download, and there are hundreds of different models. Obviously, I cannot show you all the 100 models. I'll try to show you some of the interesting ones and any of the randomly selected models so that you develop the interest into this. Pac-Man game most of you might have played. So select the difficulty level and all these moving things are the nodes. Okay, and then there are some relationship that what commands have been given to them. Should I move left or right, or like we have multiple connections. So this is also a social network, and while playing, if I do this and let's move to some other library. So fractals are the self-replicating graphical or images which you study in computer graphics. Okay. Everything is made up of, they say that in nature, everything is made up of small basic geometry. It is replicated over a period of time. I'll search the Google and show you some fractals, then you will be able to visualize this. You see this same tiny thing multiplying itself again and again and again, it leads to structures like this. So this is called a fractal. So what are fractals? They are also social networks of small things expanding the network, and suddenly we see a very big object in front of us. Okay, so basically they are made up of self-replicating graphs. So triangles making up bigger triangles, and ultimately we see something which is in front of us, which is quite big in inches or feet. Ultimately, everything is made up of small atoms and molecules, and beyond that, it is string theory and the Large Hadron Collider and many, many other things are there. So how do they interact with the similar entities, and now they form something like which we were seeing over here. So fractals. So one or two I would like to show more, and this is a bushfire or a wild forest fire. So if the density of the trees is very high, so fire from one tree would be traversing to the other tree. So if the trees are placed very far away from each other, if one of the trees catches fire may not spread to the other tree. So quite similar to social networks. If the number of friends with me is 5, and anything that I say may not travel very far away compared to if I have 1,000 friends. Okay, so fire depends on the density of trees. So let's start with a less dense forest, and I give the command fire to start from A direction to B direction. So it didn't travel. This edge you see would be a very small fraction of red color because the density of trees is very less. If I increase the density, the fire starts, and fire was not able to spread. So what is fire? It's just like our communication viral video. If the video is not very popular or interesting, it might not become a viral video. If the video is interesting, it will become a viral. Firstly, it has to be interesting. Secondly, the number of rewiring and connections has to be high so that it travels. So let me increase the density. Obviously, the spread of fire would depend on humidity, temperature, wind direction, type of the wood of the trees, and some other things. So in simulation, you cannot take care of everything, but you have to be near to the accurate values. It's a very dense So again, the fire is not spreading. Focus on these green areas which are untouched by fire. These are those nodes which have very low betweenness, very less number of connections. They never get to know anything. There are always some people who don't have updated news. Okay. So it's like that. One more model. So this is climate change. So climate change, it depends on what is the CO2 level in the atmosphere. Okay. What is the level of carbon monoxide, methane, many of the parameters are there. What is the content of clouds? Okay. What's the angle of incidence? What is the length, longitude and latitude of your location? So in general, a model has been created. Okay. So we are going to set up sun brightness higher. Albedo is a concept of heat retention and absorption and reflection in the atmosphere. If I summarize it in one line, if I add some clouds, add some CO2 molecules over here. So what do the CO2 molecules do? They produce a greenhouse effect. They trap the incident and reflected rays. So the temperature of Earth or the atmosphere keeps on increasing. So these are the sun rays. Any ray which is striking on the cloud, it is traversing back to the upper atmosphere. And in between over here, we have some molecules. And consider everything to be a node, and these are the edges. So we have some graph of global temperature, how it is. And this is how the scientists, this is one of the methods how scientists are able to predict that at the end of this century, the amount of sea level would be this much. The average global temperature would be this much. Okay. So simulations are used. So one of the methods of simulation is social networks. So I hope you are in pace, you are enjoying these social networks. Or should I make it more interesting and get into the Python programming and R programming? Or this one is fine? Okay, any questions, any discussions? Any questions or discussion so far? Students, come up with your doubts, come up with your ideas. So 42 participants apart from me. I cannot name, like, what do we do in the lectures? We call out the names of every student so that they wake up and they say something. So 42 is a big number. I cannot address all of you. It's a common message for everybody. Anybody who would like to say anything, that you are getting it, you're not getting it, how it is not working. Is it fine? Somebody wants to say something? Akansha? Anvi, Simran? Ankita? Akshit? Okay, how to analyze any business network. Now, business network is, firstly, you need to specify what type of business network is it. Is it an online shopping network, like Amazon is an online shopping network. The nodes are the different millions of products that we have on display. Okay, what you are going to buy is what you are being shown over there. So more important items and what is the history, my purchase history. Those things would keep on appearing again and again. And also while signing up for eBay, Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, Tata Chroma, or any other thing, social network, I would have given some information to them. Like, who am I? Okay. My name, my PIN code, my location. They get some of the things I provide to them. Some of the things they get from Google or internet service provider. So they know me. So they would try to show those nodes to me, which I am more probable to buying. So this is one type of business network. Okay, so showing those things which you might be tempted to buy. similar things they happen when you go to a local kirana store also. Okay, they would have displayed many of the things which the children like to grab the most. They are the things which are displayed at the outer counter. Okay, so anything that you need for your daily needs like chilies or wheat flour or something, which is an important commodity and it need not to be advertised, that can be placed at a outside of the warehouse also. So business network means what type of business you are in. Okay, what things you want to show and what things you want to have lesser important, and who your customers are, and something like this. So you have to specify that. Any other question? Any discussion? We can map the human behavior and availability of resources during COVID times also through this. And like, is it a question or you're telling something? Akanksha, can you be specific about this? You can unmute and you can talk to me. I'm not clear what you have written. Yes, Akanksha, tell me. Can we map the human behavior? Because you had not put any question mark or was not very clear. Yes, there has been a lot of research that how do people respond to different activities. Like if you remember last year when the COVID lockdown had just started, Doordarshan had started up with the concept of retelecasting their TV serials. So I did a research on Twitter that are the people liking it or not? Because liking and disliking is a part of human behavior. Okay. Then there was a thali banging event. There are some research papers. There was some free webinar series conducted in different parts of the world. Are the people liking it or not? Some freebies, some discounts by the network service providers. How do you react to that? Do you say bad words or do you say good words? That is your human behavior that you portray on the social networks. Yes, it is being done, and it is not only in COVID times, in general election times also. Like recently there was Bengal elections and some other elections were there which were very popular. So anything which is creating a hype on the social networks, which appears to be popular, maybe on the negative side, maybe on the positive side, there's a general tendency of people that they vent out their feelings on social networks. So that is your behavior. Okay. Like, how do you sit in a bus? How do you sit in a classroom? How do you behave in your living room? That is your human behavior. How do you portray your feelings? Do you speak bad words or do you say something or do you criticize or you take the things in a lighter mood or do you share jokes and videos? So that tells you what is your mood. Okay. If at 2 a.m. in the night I am studying and suddenly I share a YouTube video that I am watching this song, it shows an abnormal activity. Okay. Why at 2 a.m. I am still awake and doing this? So you can track down all these activities with your filters. So Python and Twitter and Python and R and MATLAB, they provide you a lot many libraries for specific purposes. Okay. For the sentiment analysis, for natural language processing, for catching particular hashtags, how do you respond to them? Polling is done on Twitter. And Ankita, please elaborate your question. Ankita? I see a comment from you. Can you elaborate what do you want to convey out of this? Polling is done on Twitter. You have written this. Ankita, are you there? What I understand from this is polling is done on Twitter. You can create some election events and any of the nodes whom you authorize to take part into the polling, they will be giving a thumbs up or thumbs down. And based on the number of thumbs up and thumbs down, you can create the final results of the polling. So this is what I understand from your this line. Any other question, any other discussion? So we can take a break, and I would suggest all the audience that in the meantime, you download NetLogo. okay, netlogo, netlogo. Try to use the models and libraries, and if you find any interesting ones, do share with us when we resume the session. And I would allow you to show your models library. Okay, there are many, many models library. One or two I would also like to select and start when we resume the session. So it's 11:25, and we can resume the session at 12:30. Fine. Everybody be back at 12:30, and we will definitely have some interesting visualizations and graphics and some other discussions. Okay. So see you again at 12:30.